I don't necessarily feel like this is about the ending of a relationship. I feel like more so than anything, it is about closure in a way where it's going to be easier for the both of you to move on or to move on together. But given the fact that we're looking at the Five of Cups as the overall, it makes me wonder here if you're not going to be let down or disappointed by this person. So the first thing that you're showing is the Six of Wands. And I think that the reason why we're looking at victory and recognition is because it looks like at some point in the past, this person was wanting to, start things with you, wanting to start over, wanting to build this relationship, looking at the Page of Pentacles. Because we're talking about the communication and taking information and applying it in a way where we get to build something practical and realistic. So it would make sense that for you, it's like, yes, that is what I want to do. That's ultimately where I want to see things go. Then you move into the King of Wands and then them showing the Wheel of Fortune. I actually see that as a good thing. I don't necessarily feel like anything is repeating itself here. I think that what's happening here is that, there is going to be like an opening, so to speak. I almost look at the Wheel of Fortune as like things start to work out in a way where, we get to realize this relationship or, start this relationship or rebuild. You showing the King of Wands, I think, is referring to them and you. So with the King of Wands, whether you're dealing with male or female, fire sign, right? But in terms of you, the King of Wands would really show, the passion and determination here. And it's replaying out, I think, with the Queen of Wands in a very different way. But when it comes to like, an opportunity opening up here and things kind of turning in that direction, I think that the both of you are kind of like on track here in terms of, having the passion and the drive and the wisdom here to make this relationship work. And of course, the man of passion, being extremely attracted to this person. But for you, I mean, absolutely coming in with the Six of Wands, right? Like, yes. Now, with the Two of Cups, though, and looking at the Page of Swords, things start to change. So I think that you're really trying to understand what is going on with them, because the Page of Swords would suggest here that they may be communicating things to you that aren't exactly what you want to hear. I think that the relationship is important to you and that you feel like the connection is being made, that you are seeing things the same way. But the Page of Swords, especially with the Five of Cups being there, saying that it's not. They're not exactly telling you the things that you want to hear. They're not giving you full information. Because I always look at the Page of Swords as needing to ask more questions, not having all, of this information, which is why we need to go, well, why? Why? But this is somebody who isn't exactly giving you, full disclosure. There's a huge difference for me, a huge difference between the Page of Swords and the Knight of Swords. The Knight of Swords, I don't ever question. They are definitely telling the truth. Their harsh action is the only thing that is put into question. The Page of Swords, though, that's a little shyster to me. And I don't think that this person is intentionally trying to lie to you, but there are things that they may not want to tell you. Or, like I said, they're telling you things that you don't want to hear. So it's like the opportunity opens up, but for some reason, they step back almost. And for you, I think that, it's definitely going to be emotionally hard to deal with, especially considering that, with the Two of Cups, you're looking at this connection. And I think that you're really trying to understand what the hell it is that they're trying to tell you. So then you move into this place with the Seven of Pentacles where I feel like you're obviously reevaluating everything. Everything that you've put into this, everything that you've done, all of the pain and the suffering that was caused to get to this place where you start to get to see things develop, right? But then again, are you happy with what you're seeing? Is there room for further growth? Is there a different way that, things can be done here? With the Queen of Wands, what I worry about here is that there is a blow to the ego where there may be like confidence lost in yourself, in the relationship, that fire, that passion and determination to get what you want ultimately has been turned upside down. And that's kind of how I see that with the Five of Cups being there. But it's only because it's like, that is what you wanted, but then it's like they changed their mind almost. Now, with the World, this is, you know, finally getting some closure on this. And it could mean the end of the relationship, but this combination is interesting to me because I look at this and I think that you're going to have to create closure for yourself because you're not going to get it from this person. Anything that they communicate to you is not going to be enough for you to get the kind of closure that you're wanting. So it may be that you're trying to take the next steps here to get closure, but they're also wanting this issue to be over with. But the thing is the Page of Swords is not the right way to do that. And then the Two of Wands. Well, what do we do next? What do we do next? For some of you, that blow that I was talking about here with the Queen of Wands may have to do with something that is confusing to you because they're not telling you everything. Okay. And it's just, for me, when I look at the Page of Swords, I think, well, why didn't you just tell me? You know, because I'm trying to understand, but if you're not going to tell me everything, then how the hell do you expect me to understand? And I think that that confusion is coming from, you know, with Justice being there, is something that they're needing to fix or correct in their life. And this could literally be about them, you know, needing to either separate, divorce, or that, you know, they may have done something wrong that they need to fix. But ultimately, it's leading into a place where they need to be secure with, you know, themselves. That to me is kind of what the Queen of Pentacles is talking about. So it's almost like, I think that they're going through a situation possibly with, you know, another person. But as far as the King of Cups goes, I look at that and I think they're trying to be a little bit more open. I think that they're trying to be a little bit more available to you. And I think that by them acting that way, they're showing that, you know, you do have what it takes to kind of make whatever you need to have happen in this relationship, right? Because with the Magician, it's really about whether or not you feel like you have the confidence to create what you want. Do you have the ability? Do you have the skills? Do you have the tools, right? What is it that you're wanting to manifest out of this? But that only depends on whether or not this person is supporting what you are trying to do, what you are trying to create. Given the fact that you're needing to look at everything and reevaluate it and go, well, if it's not good enough, then, you know, maybe we can make something better here. The Moon and Justice. This is where things get a little bit sketchy for me because you're clearly confused. You're confused by them and you're confused by what it is that they feel like they need to make amends for. Now, this may be that they're trying to explain to you that, yes, I want to have this relationship, but, you know, there is not really much that they can do without getting closure on something in their life. And they may not be really telling you everything. And that may be where the confusion is coming through. But I almost feel like they're trying to tell you, just trust me. Just trust that I'm going to take care of this, if that makes sense. You know, you would not be in this place of the Magician where it's like, okay, you know, great, right? Let's make this happen. Let's make this a reality. But that disappointment, I think, is setting in because there is something that they need to close out and finish. And with Justice, I mean, you could be talking about, you know, simply a court case, something that, you know, they may have to fess up to. It could be separation, divorce, you know, anything like that. But I think it's on them. It's something that is separate from you, for sure. Because you wouldn't be confused about what they did wrong. You know what I'm saying? And I don't think that they feel like they've done anything wrong other than saying that, yes, I want to build this relationship with you, but there's some shit that I got to deal with. You know, but do they follow through on that, though, is the other thing. So what do we do now? for them, with the Queen of Pentacles, you know, I almost feel like not only is this about another person involved, but I also feel like I said, this is really about them needing to get to a place where they can create security for themselves. They need to feel secure with themselves. But then that essentially means that what they were initially coming in with is not, you know, going to happen just yet. So for you, you may be waiting on them to kind of like figure out what course of action they're going to take. But if you get, you know, this huge blow and this is how you feel about it, where you feel a lack of confidence in feeling, you know, disappointed and let down by this person, are you considering taking a different course of action? You know, it just depends on how you're looking at this. But clearly here, they have not been very clear with you about what they are actually dealing with and what they're actually intending to do. You know, because they're not giving you the answers. They're not giving you all of the answers that you need. So this could come down to, you know, maybe you need to find security for yourself and find some closure with this. But like I said, I mean, other than the world, you know, I'm not really seeing this situation being over with. That's up to you and the choice that you make and the actions that you decide to follow through on after this. The Page of Cups. So, you know, I don't think that you really truly know if this person feels the same way. So, first of all, past life relationship. I look at this card and I think that if this is a past life relationship and you guys, if you've been through the relationship cycle with this person before, this is it. This is the last time we need to heal those issues so that you don't have a repeat of the same shit over and over and over again, right? But this may be why, though, this person is a persistent thing in your life. So, first of all, with the Five of Cups and the Queen of Swords, I think the reason why you're looking at yourself as single is because they did something very wrong. Very wrong. I do believe that you are the Queen of Swords in this situation, being focused on this person from the past and the pain that they caused you. And clearly they're trying to apologize. And I don't think it's that easy for you to trust, because Temperance would suggest that you're not, you know, so willing to do that. Right? And it really started pouring out. So now with the Three of Wands, this is about, you know, two people who realize that they feel the same way about each other. But the problem is when you're looking at the Page of Cups, it's like somebody can't spit it out. It's like, damn it, why can't I just tell them how I feel? It's like they're having trouble doing that. So I don't know that you know that they feel the same. And then the Ten of Swords, damn man. So if they can't express to you how they feel so that there's at least some kind of certainty about, you know, you feeling the same way, that's going to create a painful ending in the situation where it's completely over with. I really think that you're dealing with a person that is not that easy to forgive. There are too many doubts. There are too many questions. You know, the Seven of Wands would suggest overcoming that, but because you're looking at the Queen of Swords in the way that you respond to them trying to apologize, it's just not that easy for you to trust. You're not in any kind of a rush to do that. And I really think that with the Hermit, you're really looking at it going, you know, is this the relationship that I want? Is this what I wanted out of this? And I think that for a lot of you, you get to a point where if they don't speak up, if they don't say something to you, then it's definitely over. The Page of Wands, oh boy, the Tower, and then the Knight of Cups. They're really trying, but I think that there's a reason why there's going to be separation. Okay. Now, and you know, like I say, when it comes to these, you can flip the script on this, but first of all, with the Ace of Wands, what's interesting to me is that, you know, there is an indication of, you know, the past that needs to be moved on from, right? Past issues, all of those things. But we're talking about new passion, you know, and again, the new beginning here. But it's, they want you to get wrapped up in them Or it can be the other way around here, because the Page of Wands is about looking beyond appearances. Okay, so I want you to look past some things about myself, and I just want you to kind of like get wrapped up in me. Sometimes it's a good thing, sometimes it's like, wait a minute, you know, open your eyes. There's something that needs to be seen. So moving into the Four of Pentacles, though, you know, I think that you at least consider a new beginning with this person. The problem is with the Tower. At some point, you know, there has been a deception and cheating, and then of course there's the jealousy that shows up there. But this is somebody who needs to try a little bit harder. You know, you need to try a little bit harder here to, you know, rebuild this relationship, get the passion back going, right? Now, when you move into the Five of Swords here, this is about overcoming feelings of inadequacy. And I think that that is the major issue moving forward. But everything underneath here is indicating that you're dealing with a person who is trying to push you. I feel like they're pushing you. They want you to connect with them. They want you to have an experience with them. They don't really care if you feel bad or what your feelings are. And that's just me being honest with that damn Five of Swords being there. This bothers me. Yeah, man. And then the Lovers. All right, Leo. And, you know, again, it's general. But if this is somebody that, you know, you're in a relationship with, and this should have been a committed relationship, I think that you're dealing with somebody that really will never get past giving into temptation, okay? Because I look at the Lovers and I think that, you know, they don't really care that they have made you feel like you weren't enough, because that doesn't matter to them. And with the Knight of Cups being there, it's like, you know, constantly looking for the next encounter. And then you have the Lovers there where, you know, you're there and they're constantly tempted somewhere else. And that's what that feels like to me. Looking at the Two of Wands, and this is about, you know, the flirting, getting to know each other, right? Getting to understand each other. And I think that that's what they are, you know, trying to do with you. But I don't know that you're actually having it. And it makes me wonder what it is that you learn about them that is having to do with the Tower. But there's something about this person that constantly brings up feelings of jealousy and inadequacy for you. Now, again, like I said, we can flip the script on this, but this is the same old shit. This is the same old shit that you have been dealing with in this relationship for a while. And maybe it is time for you to separate. You know, maybe it's time to take a break here and let them figure it out rather than, you know, putting you in these kinds of situations or these feelings here where you don't feel like you're good enough because they're giving their attention to somebody else, or, you know, them literally like cheating here.